Hello, my beautiful friends, and it's time for us to discuss our absolute last moon aspect of 2019 that's happening. And this one is going to be happening on December 25th, 26th, depending on where you are in the world. But either way, it is happening at 4 degrees of Capricorn. So make sure you grab your chart and you find wherever 4 degrees of Capricorn is at for your chart. Now, I do want you to keep in mind that while this is our new moon for the month, this is a new moon solar eclipse and it's a partial. So what that means for you is that instead of having this moon phase that's going to last just 4 weeks and you see the impact of it, this particular eclipse energy is going to give you an impact for about 6 months. So what is begun or what is adjusted here, what fresh perspectives you get at this time, they will carry over with you for about 6 months. Now, a couple things to also keep in mind about this particular eclipse cycle, because eclipses and moons work in phases and in cycles. This particular moon marks the end of a cycle that began for us with the solar eclipse that happened on July 2nd this year. So think back, what was going on for you July 2nd, 2019? What did that eclipse energy bring to your attention or bring to your table that you were working with at that time? Because it's going to end that set of energy, but now it's going to bring a beginning of a cycle that is starting here and will go all the way until June 5th of 2020. So these are the areas that you're going to continue to check up on and check up in. And so we're going to make the adjustments in these particular areas. Now, this particular solar eclipse happening right here is going to also have ties. And I want you to pay attention to the lunar eclipse that's going to be coming January 10th of 2020. So you've got a couple different cycle times to tap back into and see what's happening so you can watch how the cycle is working in, with, and for you, okay? Now, if you have no idea what the difference between any of this is, let me give you an explanation really quickly. A solar eclipse is still a new moon for the month. So the actual aspect that we're going to see is that the sun and the moon are together, right? So they are traveling together. We get a new moon. And when the new moon and the sun and the moon come together and we get this new moon aspect, anything's possible. Right? It's a fresh start. It's fresh perspective, fresh eyes. It gives us an opportunity to look over maybe old behaviors or things like that and say, yes, I'd like a fresh start in this particular area. In all of the energy of Capricorn, it could be in structures in your life, places of work or authority or things like that. Certainly, it could give you a little bit of influence of your home life as well, could be getting a fresh perspective in this energy. But the difference between just the new moon that's going to give us 4 weeks of impact is that this solar eclipse is going to give us 6 months of impact. And what happens is that, yes, the sun and the moon are brilliantly here together, but the moon passes between the sun and the earth, but it darkens out the sun a bit at a solar eclipse. But this one is just a partial eclipse, which, what does that mean? Typically, when we have an eclipse, it can be a total eclipse where there's a blotting out of that sun energy. So it's a complete reset to your emotions, to your projects, to things like that. Because this is just a partial eclipse, it means we're gonna see those crispy edges of the sun still behind there with the moon. So it tells us that we're not starting anything new. Even though this is a new moon, you're not starting a fresh project necessarily, but you are getting fresh perspective, fresh eyes, fresh progress, fresh growth on something that you've already been working on. And you can tell that by looking back at the cycle dates that I gave just a little bit, and you can see how things have been progressing along, okay? Now, the astrology of this particular solar eclipse new moon is absolutely brilliant. Now, first and foremost, we have got this moon that's happening, and it's a new moon, so we like that. It means we're going to go forward with something new. But it is also in conjunction here with Jupiter energy. Now, Jupiter has at this time moved into the energy of Capricorn. So Jupiter has made a move himself. He has moved forward. He has moved on. So at this particular new moon solar eclipse, this is also an energy in conjunction with our biggest benefic planet, our planet that likes to expand and to move forward. This is our move forward. This is fortunate. This is benefic. This is prosperous. This is such a positive energy. So whatever it is that you're continuing to look over that you've been working on for some time, it's getting positive reinforcement for change. With Jupiter in the energy of Capricorn, he has said, look, I'm going to bring wisdom to your structures. I'm going to bring wisdom. I'm going to bring growth. I'm going to bring positive change and forward motion to your structures. And I'm going to help you focus on the path that you're trying to take. So this conjunction is absolutely fortuitous for us. You guys, there's so much good luck. There's so much fortune. There's so much growth and enhancement available in this particular moon. And you're going to see that growth over the next 6 months, which is absolutely, absolutely brilliant. Now, we've also got this aspect in here where we've got Uranian energy coming to the table, right? We've got this new moon, solar eclipse, and that Jupiter conjunction, and they are all walking and talking over here, connecting to this Uranian energy. So this brings in something new. This brings in something exciting. So we've got this conjunction in a trine to Uranian energy. Remember, the trine is the pocket of energy that's easy. This is harmonious. So we've already got positive change, growth, good stuff available, and then we put that in harmony with, let's do it different energy, right? Now, what I love the most about this particular energy is that not only is it a trine, so we know there's some harmony, Uranus is still retrograde in the energy of Taurus. So anything that's been going on that you need a fresh perspective of, maybe it's your money or the things that you've been doing in terms of value, the things that have had value in your life, because Uranus is still in retrograde, you have the opportunity to get these fresh eyes, these fresh perspectives, these fresh pathways, maybe even it's fresh connections and collaborations to move something forward differently than you have been doing, and it will bring in new value to you. Not just new value like I value this, which is absolutely important. Self-confidence could be coming to your table. This could also just be fortunate finances coming via the way of getting a fresh perspective on how to positively take your new wisdom and structures forward. So this is absolutely a wonderfully ambitious energy that we've got at this particular new moon solar eclipse that will last you 6 months. So I hope that every single one of you grabs your chart, looks at where this energy is happening for you, look at this exciting influence of energies happening here. Plus, we've got a connection that'll be happening as well between Pluto and Mars, which is determination, it's focus, it's movement. This is a lot of, again, positive energy that is to your favor to take action in your forward direction of growth, but in a way that builds solid foundations that you can continue to stand on for the next 29 years, and that you have a set of cycles that you can check on as you continue to travel forward from now and into 2020. So please let me know where these are happening in your chart, and what is the fortune you're even ready and wanting to have come for you? What's the growth that you are ready for in these areas, and where are you willing and ready to do a little bit of innovation? A little bit of getting out of your box, new long-range planning that is to your greatest good. Let me know that in the comment section down below. And I, of course, hope that you have had a brilliant holiday. I hope if you're interested, you've gotten signed up to be in the inner circle. There will be plenty of studying there. There will be studying here at Stormy Grace. I hope you've taken advantage of your 60,000 subscriber gift. All of these things are available and at your fingertips right now for you to experience astrology. So I look forward to seeing you going forward over the next 6 months, over the next year, and anytime in between there, okay? All right, you guys, like this video, comment, share, subscribe, take advantage of this brilliant moon energy that we're going to have, and stamp out the next 6 months for yourself of absolute success, okay? I love you guys. Bye.